In today's class, we are going to discuss on pump and the importance of it, and then we will be covering the types of pumps and the factors affecting the selection of the pump. Okay, we are into module 5, and in the module 5 we have discussed on the distribution methods, okay, and the types of the distribution system. And then in the fifth module, we are into the last part, that is regarding the pumps we are going to discuss. In the water supply, we cannot able to imagine the supply of water without pump. Normally, we suggest that the water supply should be under the gravity flow, but in all the topographical conditions, that particular the supply of water with the help of gravity is usually not possible. Okay, so in such circumstances, we require the help of pumps. So without pump, we cannot able to imagine the supply of water without pumps. So pumps are being very most essential part of your water supply. So this is that is the reason why we are studying regarding the pumps. Okay. So in the pumps, now we'll see why it is first of all very very important. Okay. Now whenever we are going to have the source at downside. Okay. Whenever we are going to have the source from downside, and then we want to, when we lift the water to the village, which is present village or town or city, which is situated at an upstream portion or towards the upside portion, at that particular condition, what we want is, we need to, in order to lift the water from the source to the village, what we want the help of pumps. Okay, and this is one particular condition. Sometimes we are going to have the undulations. Okay, now suppose if your source of water is here, okay, then again you are going to have the undulation, then again might be the slope is like this, then again it might, the slope is going to increase again. So at that particular condition, what we want is, we want to have this particular pump is going to be very very important aspect. In order to, what is the work of pump? In order to lift the water from the low level or the low altitude to the higher altitude, we want these, the help of pump. So pump is going to be very important aspect in the our water supply project. Okay, now in the majority of the cases, few of the cases, we are going to have the water by the gravity flow. We are going to supply the water in very few cases. We will be supplying the water with the help of gravity flow. But in the majority of the cases, what is going to happen is, we want to lift up water from a river or from a lake to the treatment plant. At that particular condition also, we may require pumps, or from treatment plant to the, in order to distribute it to the village, there also we need the help of pump. Okay, wherever there is an uplift is there, then we want the pump. Okay, now let us see what are the necessities of the pump. Okay, so first necessity is to lift the water from the source of a supply to where we want, to the delivery point. Okay, to lift the water from the supply to the delivery point, we need to have these particular pumps. To lift the treated water to the overhead tank, many a times what happens is, we are going to get the treated water from the treatment plant, and somewhere it is going to be stored, okay, into the downside portion. Then from that particular source, storage source, we need to supply the water to the overhead tank. Okay, so at that particular condition also we require these pumps. Okay, to deliver the treated water to the consumer taps at a reasonable pressure. Sometimes what happens is, from your treatment plant, might be there is a downfall is there, then again the residential area which is going to be where the water has to be supplied, might be again after having the downfall, again it is going to be situated at upstream portion. For example, this is your source of treatment, your storage source. Okay, then might be here downfall is there. Then again your locality is situated somewhere here. Till this the water will flow under a gravity. Then again till this due to this particular gravity it may the water will come due to pressure till this particular part. Then when we want to supply for this particular portion, what we want is we want to have the pump. Okay, with the help of pump we need to supply the water. So for all these reasons we are going to have the pumps. Okay, then the next line is to boost the line pressure. That is, in order to increase the water line, your pressure in order to increase, we want to have this particular pumps. Then to supply the water under pressure for hydrants. Okay, sometimes for fire hydrants. There might be if there is a fire accident in one particular area and the around the floor is around say 5 to 10 floor, 10 story floor is there. Then in order to lift that particular water, again we need to have these particular pumps. And under the miscellaneous conditions, that is during backwashing, pumping of the chemicals, backwashing of especially when backwashing we do for it filters. Okay, for at that particular condition we may require these pumps. And then pumping of the chemicals, then dewatering of the tanks when we want to clean it, then at those time also we require the help of pumps. Okay, then we will see what are the different types of pumps we will be using. First is the displacement pump, then airlift pump, then centrifugal pump, then miscellaneous pumps. Okay, these four types we are going to study in today's class. Probably we will be covering the displacement pump and the airlift pump. Okay, and then centrifugal and miscellaneous pumps we will be covering in the next class. Then we will be covering what are the factors affecting the selection of pump. So first factor is the capacity of pump. Okay, depending upon the capacity, suppose the height is too much. Okay, for if the height is around say 30 meters, okay, if you provide the half HP pump, then it may not lift that particular water to 30 meter. Okay, so depending upon the height and the capacity of pump, we will be fixing the usage of which kind of how much capacity of the pump we should use. Then the number of pump units required and at one particular location, if you want to send the water from the treatment plant to the consumer, there might be having too many undulations at those particular points. How many number of pumps we may require. So again it depends on that. Then suction condition. Okay, then fourth is your discharge conditions and a variation in the load. How much amount of discharge we want at that also is going to decide the selection factor affecting the selection of pump. Then the floor space requirement, how much amount of floor space we are going to have it. Then flexibility of operation. Okay, so there also we are going to decide what kind of a pump has to be set up. Starting and priming characteristics of the pump, and then the initial and the running cost that has to be maintained. That also we are going to all these factors will be affect the selection of pump. So these are the some of the 8 factors which is going to affect the selection of pump. Now we are going to discuss on the types of pump we are going to have. First is the displacement pump, airlift pump, centrifugal pump and miscellaneous pump. Now we are going to discuss on the displacement pump. In displacement pump we are going to have the 2 types in it. One is reciprocating pumps and the rotary pumps. So we will discuss on a displacement pump regarding the reciprocating pump and the rotary pump. First we need to know what is a displacement pump. Okay, the displacement pumps, these are those in which the liquid is sucked and then it is actually pushed or displaced due to the thrust exerted on a moving member. Okay, that means we are going to have the working of it as it the name is having the displacement. So whenever the plunger or a piston, which is it is completely dependent upon the momentum of the plunger or the piston. So whenever it is going to move inward and outward, so sufficient amount of suction is going to be generated, and then from that particular section the water is going to be restored into the pipe. And then whenever the your plunger or a piston is going to move outwards, then it is going to be moved from the displacement valve. See, this particular your displacement pump is completely dependent upon the momentum of a piston up on a plunger which is connected to the crank. Okay, so this is what your displacement pump is. See, you can hear, you can see there is a displacement valve is there, and then a suction pump is suction valve is there. So in these two particular pipes the water will be getting discharged or it is going to be suctioned. So this is nothing but your reciprocating pump. So we will see what is a reciprocating pump exactly. The your displacement pump consists exactly. The pump consists of one or more chambers which are alternatively filled and emptied. That is regarding, I was speaking on the displacement and suction kind of a valve. Okay, so now we will see the regarding the reciprocating pump. This is one of the most common displacement pump that we are going to use it. It is consisting of either, this is nothing but your piston or plunger, which moves, which is going to move through in close fitting cylinder, which is connected to the suction and delivery pipes. So the S what I have written is a suction pipe, and the D is what I have written is the delivery pipes, as it is shown in the figure. The suction and delivery pipes are provided with the non-return valve, which admits the water in one direction only. Okay. Now we will see the working of your reciprocating pump. During the suction stroke, that when the piston is going to move outwards, okay, when it is going to move outwards, the vacuum is going to create it inside the cylinder, which enables the atmospheric pressure acting on a liquid surface in the sump below to force up the liquid fill inside this particular cylinder. Okay, when we are going to have the suction, it is going to be this particular piston will be moved outwards, and this suction valve is going to get open, and the water is going to be stored inside it. During the inward motion of the plunger, the liquid is in the cylinder is forced up to the delivery pipe. Okay, during the inward motion, it is going to, the displacement pipe is going to get open. Okay. During the operation, the suction valve, during this particular operation, the suction valve is going to be get closed, and the D valve is going to be open. Okay, so the water is going to be delivered to the consumer. Okay, the piston or plunger is going to be moved by a crank. This particular thing, it is we call it as an crank. Okay, so this is regarding your reciprocating pump. Now we will see what is a rotary pump. As the name is indicating, in the rotary pump, it is going to have the two gears to it, okay, which is going to rotate in an opposite direction. These rotating elements is going to fix in a casing. Okay, it is going to be fixed in a casing so that the water is going to be drawn from the suction, and then it is going to be withdrawn from the discharging end. Okay, these two particular gears is going to be get fixed into these teeth, and it will be continuously rotating. Okay, now in the rotary pump there are no valves are required, and the flow is continuous in this particular rotary pump. Okay, the pumps which is used in the principle of the rotary displacement are, it is going to have the gear, it is going to have the lob, screw, then the moino and vane pumps. These pumps are not used in the common in case of your waterworks. So normal we will be using the reciprocating pumps normally rather than the rotary pumps in case of the displacement pump. In the displacement pump, we will be using the reciprocating pump rather than the rotary pumps. Now we'll cover the next type of a pump is nothing but the air lift pump.
As the name is indicating, the air lift pump, the air is going to help in lifting the water from the underground surface. So this is what the air lift pump, underground surface or wherever we are going to store the water. So this is what regarding the air lift pump. In the air lift pump, we are going to lift the water from the with the help of the air pressure. So in your airlift pump, it is having a compressor is used to force the air into the small diameter pipe. Here, from here we are going to compress, we are going to send the air pressure, and then when we are going to send it, if the water is there in this particular your pipe, when we force an air, what is going to happen, the more amount of air pressure is going to be get created, and this air is going to enter into the water which is present over here, and then it is the water is going to be uplifted and it is going to be taken out from this particular system. So this particular smaller diameter pump, we call it as an air pump. And the bigger diameter pump, this is nothing but your bigger diameter pump. The outward section is nothing but your bigger diameter pump. We call this particular pump as the education pipe, or we are going to call it as a discharge pipe. The inward, the pipe, the smaller diameter pipe, whichever is there inside, we call it as an the air pipe, and the outward the bigger diameter pipe, whichever is there, we call it as an the education pipe or a discharge pipe, from where we are going to get the water to the consumer. Okay, so this is regarding your the air pipe, okay, or air lift pump. When air is forced into water, the air and water mixture is going to be get created inside your the water, okay, and the specific gravity is lower than water. Due to this, the water is going to rises, okay, and then it is going to be discharged out. So what happens when we blow air, the specific gravity is lesser than the water. So when we want to lift the water, this air and water mixture is going to be created, and then we are going to get the water outward. So this is regarding your air lift pump. So in today's class, we have discussed regarding what is the necessity of pump, okay. Then we have discussed on what are the different types of pump. In that, we have discussed on displacement pump, airlift pump, centrifugal pump, and miscellaneous. We have discussed these two, centrifugal pumps and miscellaneous pumps. We are going to discuss in the next class. And then we have discussed on the factors affecting the selection of the pumps. Okay. In that, we have studied the 8 factors which are there in the factors affecting the selection of pump. Then we have discussed on the displacement pump. In the displacement pump, we have studied the reciprocating pump and rotary pumps. The reciprocating pump and the rotary pump we have discussed, and normally the reciprocating pump will be utilized. And then we have studied the airlift pump. In the airlift pump, we see we are going to have the 3 types of methods. So one is a central system where the air pipe is present at the center, then POHL system, then the reservoir system. The basic principle is the same in all the system. So this is regarding the introduction of the pumps. Okay, in tomorrow's class, we will be studying on the centrifugal and the miscellaneous types of pumps which are available to us. Thank you.